Howdy folks, it is Diecast Buffet here again, and today, well, we have one of the coolest Brad Keselowski paint schemes of the season, and very well could be the best Brad K car. It's the 2021 Money Lion Ford Mustang. Here we go, folks, brand new out of the good old box, and check out this paint scheme, man. Holy cow, very reminiscent of the Worth Ford Mustang, you know, kind of the three-color pattern. This thing is sharp, man. I mean, my goodness. If you compare this car to the 2019 Moneyline car, I believe it was released with Ryan Blaney as the driver. I think Keselowski was sponsored that year as well, or Joey Logano, but they didn't make a diecast for it. So, compare this to the old Moneyline paint scheme, and this thing, I mean, blows it out of the water. This thing is absolutely amazing. So you got the Keselowski name banner right there, got the Money Line decal, Penzole Ford Mustang, got the minty fresh number 2 right there. Notice a little bit of some striping right here, that's a nice touch underneath the Sunoco decal. Got the black splitter there, very, very sharp. Over to the left side of this diecast, and you know, if you look at the old Money Line car, it's pretty much just the Penske scallops, that's pretty much it. With this though, it is a modern, very sharp, just a beautiful, well-designed paint scheme, and I'm so glad they finally got this car made in the 164 scale. I believe this car actually ran in 2020 as well, but they never made it in the 164 scale, so this is the first ever time we got this paint scheme. Just fantastic looking race car, guys. So we got Brad Keselowski right there, Ford, Pertec, PPG, Mazak, Dent Wizard, and not sure what that last logo is, maybe Penske. Auto Trader, Money Lion, Wabash National, Discount Tire, Freightliner, Snap-on, American Ethanol, number 2 right there, Cup Series, race car, and Goodyear. Over to the back end of the car here. Whoa, look at that. That looks good. The black back bumper with the number 2 right there looks really cool. There's a little bit of a blemish, though, unfortunately, on the license plate, but I mean, I'd rather have it on the license plate than the door number, you know what I'm saying? I got the Money Lion decal right there. Notice the spoiler is a little bit of a different green than the rest of the car. Now, I don't know if that's accurate to the real car or not. I'm not sure. I imagine the spoiler could be a different color based on material it's fabricated from with the real deal. Got Money Lion there as well. Over to the right side of this diecast, and of course, fellas, if you want to get new 2021 diecast, you want to pre-order 2022 diecast, heck, you want to get stuff for Christmas, and you want to get free shipping, guys, make sure to check out my code down below, Diecast Buffet, all one word, same as my YouTube username. Go over to Circle Me Diecast and use the promo code at checkout, any orders $20 or more. And I gotta say, this back wheel right here looks fantastic. Look at the paint on this side. The front wheel is very skinny, kind of lean on the paint, so to speak. It makes the tire itself look wider, but it makes the rim look smaller. But look at the back one. It looks so much more accurate to the real deal. Great job on this one, not so much on this. Now flip it over, and I mean, look how small the wheel looks on this one, and it makes the tires look gigantic. I mean, I don't know. This is how all the tires should be. And there was a time and day when the tires weren't like this. 2015, 2016 were probably the best years of the Gen 6 painted wheel era, so to speak. They're very good quality. So anyway, so the roof of the diecast right here, got a not an inverted number 2, but it's just interesting to see a black number 2 with the white outlining with the minty green background. The touch on the green, it is a different color on camera than it is off camera. I would say on camera, it's more of like a traditional mint color, like you would say like mint Oreos, mint toothpaste. But off color, it's more of a seafoam green, ironically enough. I got the Worth decal right there on the back deck lid. A little bit of a bump right there. You can see how the, what is that, a magnet there? looks like it's a little bit pushed up there, but nonetheless, man, look. I'm not really a Brad Keselowski fan myself, but I tell you what, I love some of his race cars, man. I think about all the amazing cars he's had throughout the years. Obviously, the Worth paint scheme, the Moneyline one, all the Miller Lite cars he's had. Heck, even throwing the red Apple Ale car from 2014. This is certainly one of the best ones, and I'm so glad this car got made in the 164 scale. Heck, what you could do, you could just, you could remove the number 2 on the door, because if you, a little fun fact for all the cats out there, if you take a cotton swab, right, like a toothpick, or not a toothpick, but a Q-tip, and you get a little bit of rubbing alcohol on it, and you gently brush your car with it, and I'm talking gently, you could actually eat away the decal on it and it would just leave the paint. So if I really wanted to, I could remove most of this 2 decal and I could put a 22 decal right there, or a 33 decal for Austin Cindric, or a Ryan Blaney 12, whichever. You could put a new decal on this and you could literally have all the Penske cars have this beautiful, beautiful paint scheme, which I wouldn't be surprised some cats do that, because the way it works is it eats the top layer off. You know, you have paint, decal, then clear coat, right? It's a 3-layer system. You eat through the clear coat and then it gets to the decal. You don't want to damage the paint, so that's why you got to be super careful with it. Never mind that theory, fellas. I just realized the car is actually painted white. So this is another little fun fact for you. So all this is decal. The blue or the green is all decal here, guys. Underneath it is white. So if you do that, it's actually going to just eat right through it to the white paint. So don't do that. Disregard that. But for future references, though, it's always good to know things like that. Little tricks of the trade. What do y'all think about this car, guys? I give it a 10 out of 10. We got a paint scheme of the year contender, in my opinion. And the fact that he actually won in this car just makes it even that much cooler, guys. I cannot say enough about this diecast. What a beautiful, beautiful piece. I just really wish the wheels were a little bit more accurate. We got some more cool stuff coming up here on the channel. If you haven't seen already, they had a very, very nice diecast haul coming in last week. We're still pulling cars from that. I got two Joe Gibbs Racing pieces here. Got another Brad Keselowski, another Joe Gibbs Racing piece here as well. So we got plenty of stuff to review right here on the channel, guys. I love some of these paint schemes here. And they got a crap load. I mean, a crap load of new shipments coming in. Pretty much October was a dry spell for diecast shipments. And then November hit, and then Black Friday hit. And now in December, the floodgates are open. So what I'm trying to say is there's going to be a mountain of 164s coming in. So, get your stuff before Christmas while you can, fellas, because if you don't have it, that's going to be unfortunate. But nonetheless, though, 10 out of 10 diecast here, guys. Thank you all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Of course, if you ever want to, you know, mention a diecast you want me to review, make sure to comment down below. I might have it in my collection. I can try to get that one reviewed for you. Have a great one, everybody. Like, comment, and subscribe. Diecast Buffet, signing off.